Welcome back to my channel if you are already subscribed, and welcome if you're new to my channel. Remember to subscribe to this channel so that you can learn as much as possible about men, relationships, marriages, hypergamy, and femininity. Follow me on Instagram at Seductive Sirens Group. If you need my advice, you can email me at seductivesirensgroup@gmail.com. And if you want to join my private group where I mentor women even more in depth about femininity and hypergamy, whenever you're ready to join, you can send me a DM on Instagram if you're serious about taking your life to the next level. All the information you need is in the description box below. Now, you all know I'm always revamping, so I started something new and well needed known as Siren Says. These videos will be about the questions and scenarios you ask for my advice on in my DMs. I will keep your identity anonymous, so let's jump right in. So one of my Siren students sent me a message, and I quote, it says, "I need your advice on this. So I reconnected with this guy, meaning I knew him when we were young and we had a relationship, but we were kids. Also, he moved, so we grew apart. Fast forward to the part to being an adult, we reconnected where it was him who was putting in all the effort to work to get me, making future plans for us, wanting to include me in his life with every aspect, and even introduced me to his mom, which isn't a thing that he does. And I even told him no, he doesn't have to if he isn't ready, and he still did. We were doing great. I mean, I even heard he told his mom that he was gonna get married to me next year. Then all of a sudden, a week after, he found out that the mother of his child was talking to someone he felt like that could put his child's safety in jeopardy. And he went on and on about he just wants his son full time, and if he has to fight for custody, he will. So I was so shocked that all of a sudden, that same week, while he was talking about how frustrated he is with the situation, he then stated he's confused about how he feels and realizes he has feelings for her. So I decided to confront him. He was the one over and over, time and time again, that said that he wanted her to move on because she was so argumentative, that he just can't bother. And he even stated that the way how we were together, he wished that he would have met me before her and had his son with me. I was never the one that pushed the future for us, and then over time I gave in and even moved in when he asked. Now when I confronted him, all he could say is that he's confused and he still has feelings for her, and he feels like, what if it gets worse? He doesn't want to waste my time. After wasting my time, I even asked him if he wanted to be with her, and he said no. I also asked, what is it? And he said that he is confused again and said he feels like our relationship is what he needs, but he doesn't want it and maybe it is wrong timing. Hey, I was so devastated that I moved out because I couldn't believe all the bad things he said about her and their relationship, that he would do that to me. Furthermore, all the good things, and even said that I'm the best girlfriend he ever had. Now, after everything that has happened, I see them together and she is boasting away." End of message. So, my dear Siren, I am really sorry to hear that this has happened to you, but as always, I will tell you what you need to hear so that you can learn from this experience and never relive this heartbreaking hurt again. I'm first going to start out by highlighting a couple things that need to be addressed. You first stated that you reconnected with the guy. I'm not sure if you're new to my page, but for those of you who are, once something ends, let it stay that way. I rarely see cases where exes reunite and it works out for the better than the first time. The first time is the best it will ever work out, so stop resuscitating relationship with exes because there are plenty of fishes in the dating sea and the dating pool. Secondly, you stated that in the beginning he was putting in all the work, making future plans, and even introduced you to his mom and told her that he was going to marry you. My dear, I tell women all the time, do not become impressed until you both say I do. Many women get head over heels and believe all that a man says because he said or did something. The fact that you said in the beginning and not throughout the relationship lets me know that he only did this in the beginning, which is just a method men use to get entrance to the shortcut to heaven between your legs. I can tell that you were impressed when he introduced you to his mom and told her he would marry you, but all of this means nothing, and I'm sure that you see that now. Some sons are never wrong for their mother and are never corrected by their mother, and their mother will always love them no matter what they do, even if they're toying with a girl's heart. So to all the ladies out there that are listening to this video, do not become impressed by this move. Only become impressed when you say I do at your wedding. Do not become impressed by proposals, because weddings get called off every second of the day and everybody knows almost doesn't count. We might not know if he meant those things, but moving in with him was definitely the wrong move. And here's why. He's already getting access to all wifely benefits without putting the ring on your finger. If you already live those things, but moving in with him was definitely the wrong move. And here's why. He's already getting access to all wifely benefits without putting the ring on your finger. If you already live with him, why does he need to marry you? One thing men like to do is run from commitment, especially to the wrong woman. Never live with a man until after marriage, because if you do this before, he will be unmotivated and very slow to take you to the altar, because he has you doing wife duties at a girlfriend title, and to a man, that is music to his ears and a stroke for his ego. I always tell women, choose a man who is childless or a man with children who are already grown. Understand this, when you choose a man with a child, especially a young one, he will be constantly in contact with the child's mother, consistently and constantly. That is, if he's a present father in his child's life, they both will be at graduation, sports games, and any other thing that the child will participate in that requires both parents to be present. They will be spending holidays together, whether it means he will visit the child's mother's house or the child will be coming to your house. Some women are not fond of the idea of playing mother to a child who does not belong to a who belongs to a woman that she doesn't like. All right. Also, him spending so much time around his child's mother might revive old feelings, and if he doesn't love you more than he loves her, or if he values having a family more than having you, then he will go back to the place he calls home, which is to her and that child. Also, some men, as in this case, hate the fact that another man will be around his child and raising his child, and to him that is a good enough reason to go back to her, especially if she wants him back too. So never believe anything a man has to say about another woman, because there's no sure way to know if any of it is true, because there are always three sides to a story. I'm sure if one of your exes were talking about you to a new girl, he will probably paint you out as the worst person ever, because that's what men do. They lie to get what they want, because lying works. And so they will lie to the new girl so that she can feel good and better than the ex. I know that you want to know what to do at this point, which is why you sent that message. So Siren says the only thing you can do is move on. That is your only option at this point. He has told you multiple different ways that he no longer wants to be with you, but in a nice way, just by him saying he's confused, he wish he met you before he had a child with her, and how happy they both seem together now, just tells you and shows you that he preferred her. Maybe he met you when they were going through a hard time, or him seeing her with another man made him want to work things out. It doesn't really matter what the real reason is behind his choice. What matters now is what you do from this day on, which is move on with your life. That, of course, is easier said than done, but start by first stop checking in on their life. It will make it harder for you to move on, and it will make the heartbreak hurt even more. So just focus on yourself and start dating again so that you can get your mind off him. If you need a one-on-one consultation to get my help on something that has been bothering you or something that you have been struggling with, send me a DM on Instagram at Seductive Sirens Group or email me at seductivesirensgroup@gmail.com. If you want to join my private group, you can also send me a DM whenever you're ready. Remember, all the information you need is in the description box below. So Sirens, comment below if you had an experience similar to this one, your thoughts on dating and marrying a man with a child, and any additional comments you have on this topic. Remember to subscribe to this channel for more videos, like and hit the notification bell so that you do not miss any of the videos once I post it. So this is the end of this week's Siren Says. See you next week on the next video again. This has been your relationship fairy godmother, Seductive Siren, changing the world one woman at a time. Goodbye and see you soon. Thank you.